funny. And I'm gonna fall off of this thing. I don't know why. Oh, how many calories do I burn if I do like this? I'm getting so good at the hula chair, you guys. I'm hula surfing. This thing is no freaking joke. Since we last spoke together, my last video was about the hula chair. I decided I would bring it in here into my closet where most of the time I'm hanging out, recording videos for my second channel, Banana Peppers. You guys probably already know that. And so I thought instead of sitting on a skateboard, like I normally do for some reason, I would sit on the hula chair. Because honestly, I just kind of did think that maybe it was still a little bit silly. I feel like after I was wobbling around on it a lot the other day, like I did feel a little bit of something, but I was also kind of goofing off a little bit. So I thought maybe instead of like gaining muscle tone, I had just like moved around in a funny way and thought I had worked out. But you guys, the other night I sat on this chair and filmed like 3 videos, and for the past 2 days, particularly like my inner thighs have been so freaking sore. So this thing must actually really work, and I regret sitting on it right now because literally I have been so sore. Like, it's been difficult to sit down. Today is basically a sassy Swamp Family pajama party. I'm sure I look like a hot mess right now. I had totally intended on filming a bunch of videos today, and I went out, I ran a bunch of errands, and then I came home, I ate dinner, and I just crashed. And then I woke up in the middle of the night and I still had a desire to film. So here we are. Anyway, Swamp Family pajama sassy good morning wake up party, although this video will be uploaded at 3 p.m. So hopefully you're not just waking up now, but if you are, I understand. I've been there too, but I do have a good morning beverage. I have not had Sunny Delight in forever. My grandpa used to always have Sunny Delight at his house. My grandpa never had orange juice. He just had Sunny Delight, and I think I miss the tangy, delicious, don't they send Sunny Delight into space or something with the astronauts? Hashtag not sponsored. But this is so delicious. It's like everything that I remembered. Although, how much sugar is in this? 11 grams. Is that a lot for this tiny little bottle? You guys are probably about to slap me in the face with a cold hard fact. Like, the Association of Associations says that you're only supposed to have 10 grams of sugar a day. I don't understand how people adhere to like the perfect health guidelines of what you are and aren't supposed to consume. Like, doesn't it just seem like sometimes unreasonable? Or do I just live some sort of like gluttonous sugar intaking existence? Anyway, today's a video I've been looking forward to making. We haven't done one like this in a very, very long time. And actually, I don't remember the last time I did like a big group shoe unboxing video. Maybe the last time I did one like this was in like 2011 or 2012 when I had a bunch of Jeffrey Campbell shoes that I unboxed all at once. Anyway, today I've got a bunch of new shoes and I thought that I would do a massive haul. So all of these came from Dolls Kill. I feel like I just don't wear clothes in January. Like, I just never get dressed up in January. So I feel like I got a lot of these shoes in January and they have just been sitting around waiting for outfits to go with them. First up, we have 2 pairs of Doc Martens to look at. One, I know I briefly showed you guys on Banana Peppers in my last large Dolls Kill clothing haul, but you, Swamp Family, y'all have not seen these shoes yet. So honestly, I did intend to wear these for Valentine's Day this year. That is sort of what I had in mind for these, but I ended up wearing another pair of shoes instead. This is called Pascal Flame. You know, if you're a fan of Doc Martens, you really cannot go wrong with these. I have quite a few pairs of Doc Martens in my shoe collection. I absolutely love them. I feel like I've always loved Docs ever since they were a big deal in the 90s. I just remember, like, literally kids in my school were mean. Like, if you didn't have Docs and you didn't have Nikes, like, you were basically just trash at my school. Are kids still like that? Like, what is it today? I want to know if that's still a thing that exists or if people are just like more kumbaya accepting, which I hope that they are. But like, I literally had kids that teased me so bad. Like, it was too expensive when I was a kid. Like, I feel like Nikes have always been expensive. Now I'm just going on a diatribe. I don't know. I wonder if that's why I'm, like, somehow attached to Docs. We are just getting, like, really deep down metaphysical right now. That's not metaphysical. What's the word I'm looking for? Ring, ring, Doc Martin, help me out. What's the word I'm looking for? Not metaphysical, confrontational. Philosophical! Maybe that's the word I'm looking for. But, like, is that why I'm so attached to having so many Doc Martens in my collection? Because everyone teased me and made me feel like a loser when I was growing up because I didn't have any. I finally got one pair and oh my god. We found a pair that was, like, on sale and they were, like, blue suede Docs and I loved them so much. Doc Martens! I love them! I got them. The glitter is more exposed on the main part of the boot here, so I'm not exactly sure how that would weather. I do have some other glittery shoes in my collection, but I feel like I do wear those sparingly. Kind of one of the other cool things about Docs is to kind of, like, wear them and break them in and get them scuffed in various parts and points. It really adds to the overall feel and look of the shoe, but like I've said before, you really cannot go wrong with Docs. They are so comfortable, even from day one, and the more you wear them, the more comfortable they get. I promise I won't get as talky about these second pair of Docs. My only bit of advice, especially breaking in Docs like this, which this is the same style boot, it's just in a different color, is to wear socks, because sometimes that's the only problem area that I have breaking these in, is this part will rub up against my ankle and sometimes it can just get a little chafy. 1460, they're both called Pascals. It's literally like the same length, the same number of eyelets on the front, but this is a gorgeous purple velvet. And I think that they offered this velvet in a couple of different colors. Why do I want to say the other color option was red or maybe like a burgundy? I feel like I don't have that many purple shoes in my collection. I'm looking all around in the closet and I don't necessarily even think I have one other solid purple shoe. Saw these, absolutely fell in love with them, and decided to snag them. They came with two laces. So they came with this really gorgeous satin ribbon, or they also came with just regular string laces in case you wanted to go for that look as well. Moving along, I cannot wait until summer, even though that seems so far away from now. Hopefully they are still available. I know that Dolls Kill just had a super sale over the weekend where it was like buy one, get one half off of like everything on the website. And I feel like when they do big sales like that, a lot of stuff goes out of stock. Oh my God, this is just another slice of my 90s childhood. Everything from the color of the actual shoe to the style. Dolls Kill has just relaunched Delia's. Well, not just, they did this at some point last year. I feel like ever since then, so many pieces on the website are just meant to be beautiful 90s replicas. And I definitely feel like that is what they were going for in the creation of this sandal. And I have to be honest, not many sandals appeal to me. I don't feel like in my shoe collection I have many. I don't know why that is. I guess I do. I just honestly, like, the style that appeals to me most often is just like a chunky platform boot kind of thing. I don't know. I just absolutely love this. When I was a kid, I loved wearing blue. That was like my favorite color to wear. I went through periods where I had a lot of different favorite colors. Like, it was red for a while, then it was blue. But I feel like the color I remember most wearing in the 90s was blue. I loved like wearing blue nail polish, all kinds of stuff like that. So these are just amazing. The little buckle detail is a star, and hopefully the pattern of the vinyl is coming through for you guys, because it is kind of like a, I never know if it's like proper to call this holographic. It does funny things to your eyes. Do you know what I mean? It's like a pattern that, I never know if it's a hologram or a holograph. So you guys help me out. Correct me in the comments. Moving along, I'll go ahead and show you guys this next pair of shoes since I just showed it to y'all. I feel like I have so many shoes in my collection that are this same style of like a chunky platform boot. This is just what I gravitate towards. You know what? I'm gonna go grab another pair of shoes that I have that's probably most similar to this because I always love looking at the different shapes of shoes. Anyway, I'm gonna go grab this shoe. You guys can see what I mean. I feel like I have this shoe, but in a couple of different colorways, but I find this one to be very similar and very different. Do you know what I mean? I was just trying to show you guys, I'm very drawn to this style of shoe. I feel like I'm really into the whole like cyber Y2K kind of look that I feel like is kind of becoming popularized again. Don't know if that's like the technical like style term for it, but that's how I think of it as. All of these kind of silvers and blues, and this is holographic in my mind. It's just so reflective, really kind of has like a rainbow effect. It also kind of reminds me of like the back of a CD, do you know what I mean? Where it's just kind of like that rainbow hollow. Also super adorable. The end of the laces of these shoes have these little beads on them and they're these little puffy stars. And I just think that that is an absolutely adorable detail. I've never been to a rave in my life. If I was gonna go to a rave, this looks like something that I would wear to one. Moving along, why didn't I just hold these up as a freaking example? Because once again, do you see what I mean? I love this style of shoe. And I actually almost think that this is a reworking of another Dolls Kill shoe that I've had in my collection and loved forever, which was called the Nola boot with the addition of flames. I do have a couple of flame shoes in my collection, or maybe just one. Let me know if you guys like this. Like when I'm doing shoe unboxings and stuff, do you like for me to grab other shoes in my collection to show you guys? Or do you guys find that kind of like distracting? I think I only have one pair other of flame shoes in my collection, which is so weird to me because I feel like I just love the flame motif. Even though there are some similarities, I feel like there is enough differences as well. Like I do feel like this one is more kind of like flashy, almost like biker motorcycle style for whatever reason. And I feel like this one is kind of a little bit more gothic. Am I going crazy here? Is this just a distinction in my mind? But these are by Shelly, is it Shelly's or Shelly London? Last year, a couple years ago, I saw them everywhere and I don't see their shoes and stuff anymore. They were making really cute shoes and bags and now it seems like they just flown off the planet. Love the feature of the zipper on the back. I do have other shoes like this, like I said, and I do feel like it's really easy when they don't make you like lace up this kind of shoe every single time. I love to just be able to tie it, get a perfect fit, and then zip it on and off, go on with my day. I do love like the look of the ice skate laces. Next is a pair of shoes that I know has been on Dolls Kill's website for freaking ever, and I am so happy to finally have them in my collection. And I know, well, I don't know, maybe this doesn't sound silly because I do know a lot of people have like Oscars parties, they get dressed up, all kinds of stuff like that. I am definitely going to be wearing these shoes on Oscar day, and I am really gonna try and make it back out to LA this year. I miss it so much. I have not been to LA since 2015, which just sounds insane coming out of my mouth, but I have always loved Hollywood stuff. All growing up, I really wanted to be an actress, and so I always wanted shirts that like said Hollywood or LA or like some kind of stuff like that. And I just feel like this is the quintessential Hollywood item. I think it is so adorable. There's spotlights, there's glitter, it's got a film strip around the ankle, the zipper on the back has this little star. It's got like the Hollywood Hills on the front. We have palm trees on the back. It definitely is a very out there statement shoe. You have to have a wild sense of fashion or just love Hollywood or something. I'm kind of ridiculous and I like to just have shoes I only have a couple pairs of shoes like this that I just like put on display and I never wear. You know what? I'm gonna have to pick you up because they're up so high. But I do want to share these shoes with you guys because they were given to me at a Swamp Family meet and greet forever ago. But I love having cool shoes like that just on display. I would never wear those, obviously, because they're like priceless artifacts of my life. These are a little different than that, because obviously, like, I am gonna wear these, just not a ton, but I would like to display them, I guess is what I'm trying to say. I really want to redecorate this closet, display cool fashion items like that more. Anyway, this is the longest video ever. I was like, oh, this isn't even gonna make a complete video, and like now, through the powers of my rambling, this should be like 6 different videos. Up next is another like crazy kind of out there shoe. Definitely not for everyday wear. But then again, I don't know, maybe you've got just a type of style that you would wear these every single day. I shoved paper in them so that they would hold their shape like this. I just thought that these were so cool. I don't think that they are UV light reactive or technically reflective or anything like that, but it is just that really cool transparent type of material. I mean, it almost looks solid in some lights and then it looks clear in others, like really reflective. Isn't that what I'm trying to say? The heel is very manageable, very easy to walk in. And I have some really cool socks that you guys will see that I got specifically to wear with these that look like a bunch of neon lights that I thought would look really cool on the inside of these shoes. You could wear tons of really interestingly patterned socks to really kind of like style these kind of crazy. I don't know about wearing these like with no socks. I don't know how that would look or feel. I do have another pair of like clear plastic shoes that was made by Jeffrey Campbell, and I have to admit they do get like kind of steamy if I wear them without socks, and I don't necessarily feel like that's so cute. I actually had to try and buy these twice. Like the first time I bought them, when these first got launched on the website, they sold out so fast that like I checked out, and I guess I didn't check out fast enough, and so it was like stolen from my cart. Then I got really lucky and I checked the website back a couple days later and they were there again. And last but certainly not least, we've got these bad boys, which once again do remind me of a complete like cyber kind of feeling. Like I don't know if I would say cyber goth, but they do just feel like very 90s, very chunky. Like this is definitely kind of plain shoe to be adding to my collection at this point. I kind of stopped just getting like plain black shoes, if you know what I mean, with no like extra crazy detail or color. But every now and again, there will just be a plain black shoe that I feel like I would get a lot of wear out of, that I really love the look of, or that just tug on my little 90s nostalgic heartstrings, and these were a pair of those shoes. I had something similar to this in the 90s that I absolutely, oh my god, I had these shoes, which I so wish I had not gotten rid of, but I had these shoes that were very similar to this. They weren't like as high up the leg as these. They were more like ankle boots, but they had a chunky heel like this, and me and my friend almost had an identical pair, and I wore them until the heel started coming off, and even then I would not give them up. And so I would take pieces of masking tape and tape my shoe together and still wear it. And my friend and I, we would like draw all these like cool things and like write silly phrases on the tape, and it was a lot of fun. I do really get attached to pieces of clothing, and I will just wear them beyond the point of threads, and I will still keep wearing them. I really wonder what happened to those shoes. This is why I can't declutter, you guys, because it's like the one thing that I end up throwing away, like I end up just regretting it forever and then go around on a wild goose chase trying to find it again. There we go. That's it for today's crazy big shoe unboxing. Leave me a comment down below below. Let me know which shoe is your favorite. Would you wear any of these, or are these all just kind of like a pass for you? I'd love to know. Time to get back into the swing of things with fashion videos. I got lots of exciting stuff planned. I just move at an absolute snail's pace. But if you hit subscribe, give a gator its wings, become a Swamp Family member, stick around. You'll see all the fun videos coming out in the future. Thank you guys so much for hanging out today and for watching. I love y'all so much, and I hope y'all enjoyed today's video, and I will see y'all again very, very soon. Bye!